Hello everyone and welcome to another Skill Up training we are doing at Bistory. My name is Alexander Flippheit and today we're going to talk about some Tableau server highlights. So we talk about permissions, we talk about different features we have in Tableau server, and I try to guide you step by step through a few features in Tableau server. And before we start today, let's have a look at our agenda. So you see that Tableau server, so it's not about Tableau server all the time, so we talk a little bit more about how all this, the holy trinity of Tableau. We talk a little bit about Tableau Desktop, where we can create different dashboards, different analysis we want to use later. And then we use Tableau Server to publish or upload our visualizations to a place where we can share it with everyone else, so with our company, with all our employees, so we can make it possible that everyone else can see what we create for them. So, and to do this, we will start with an empty site today. In this empty site, it's not completely empty yet, but so I use my personal site where we still see some project in there, but we will create a new project in this site and we will assign the right permissions to this one. So after we did this, we have to create some users, some new users we want to see later, and we use these users to put them into different groups, so it's easier for us to create different permissions. And we, of course, publish different workbooks. So we will create some workbooks in Tableau Desktop. We will publish them to Tableau Server later. And also, we will work with a third tool in Tableau, which is called Tableau Prep, which is more a data preparation tool. So we will create our own data flow, and we will upload this flow or publish this flow also to Tableau Server. After all of this is done, we talk about some really, really cool features like using alerts in Tableau, different subscriptions we can use, how we can save our personal view. That means when we have more than, let's say we create one dashboard and we have multiple people who are looking at the same dashboard, how can they can create their personal view? So every time they log in into Tableau server, they can see their personal view all the time. Of course, we give the people a small possibility to do some web editing stuff in our dashboards. That means when we create a dashboard, we give them the possibility later to work with our dashboards and not just use them. We can make sure they can change the colors, they can do their own analysis based on some data we publish to our server. And we also talk about a really cool feature, it's quite new, that one is called Ask Data, so we can publish some data to our Tableau server and later we can directly ask it, so hey, can you give me the sales for a specific country, and Tableau is doing all the rest for you. So this is what we're doing today. It will take nearly 1 hour, so relax and enjoy our Skill Up training. Before we start, there's also a lot of other Skill Up trainings on our website, so try to watch them all. They are really interesting, and we're trying to cover different topics all the time to make sure that you will use Tableau in the best way. So that's enough from our agenda side. So let's directly jump into Tableau Server. So let's make sure that you know what Tableau Server is. So Tableau Server is a website. It's not really a website, it's a server, which can be at your company site, it can be in the cloud, and you can access everything through your browser. So the first thing you see is normally the homepage. So you see in our homepage, I see different dashboards. I was looking at them before, and you see I have some Lord of the Ring dashboards here, some other really cool visualizations, or I can adjust everything in my homepage. But the more interesting part for me is actually the Explore part here on the left side. So what we see here in Explore are all the projects I have. So actually, these are not all the projects I have. These are the projects I have in my personal site. So what is a site in Tableau? A site can be, so you can choose different sites, depending on your administrator, of course, what he creates for you. And you see that at Bistory, I have access to different sites. And every site is completely independent with all their own users, their own groups, their own permissions. So you see that I have my personal site here, which is just called Alexander Philippide, that's me, and I'm the site administrator, so I can do whatever I want on this site. So I can add new users and no one else in other sites will see these users maybe, or I can give them their own permissions, so I can do whatever I want here. So this is actually our place where we can work. So, and you see when I go to Explore and I'm in my personal site, you see I have some projects in there. So the first one you see is the default project. Just imagine a project is nothing else like a folder on your PC. So you're creating a folder, this folder is your project, and inside this folder you can put different elements like your workbooks you create in Tableau Desktop. You can put your own data sources in there, your own Tableau flows, your own metrics. You will see all this stuff later today. So another one is just a project with some examples. So you see when I click on this one, I have some really cool visualizations in here. I really like them. So, and another one, which is a workshop that was in Frankfurt. So that is the reason why I put in the picture of Frankfurt to just demonstrate you that you can also change the appearance of a project. So our idea today is that we are going to create a new project. And the easiest way to create a new one is you just click here on new and then you can select, okay, you want to create a new project. As a site administrator, I can do this, of course. The users later, maybe I can take away the possibility that they can create new projects so they are not spamming your Tableau site. So I call this one Skill Up. So what I can do here is I can format my project a little bit so I can put some images in here. So you can see that I can put an URL in our description and then you can directly see the picture like from Frankfurt, from our workshop. So, but that's not nothing we do today. So I just want to create a new empty project, which is called Skill Up, and let's do this. So we are done. So this is our new Skill Up project. And you see when I go into our project, there's absolutely nothing in here yet. So the next step, what we want to do is we have to create some users. So we want to add some users to our Tableau site. We want to create some groups. We give them the right permissions for our Skill Up project. So not everyone should do all the same stuff, so we can change all these permissions and we will learn this now. So for when I want to create a user in my Tableau site, you see I am the only user. When I click here on the left side on users, I am the only user on my site, but I want to add a few new users. And for this one, I want to use some names we all have when we work with Tableau Desktop. Maybe you know, when you work with Tableau Desktop and you're creating your own dashboards, we use something called Tableau Superstore. So Tableau Superstore is really clean data. It's really easy for practicing. So when you want to learn something new, you want to test it, do it with the Superstore. It's really clean and easy data. So the Superstore actually is nothing else like an Excel file. And I opened this Excel file already for you. And like in a normal database, we have different tables. So in our case, we have the order table where we have some operational data. So someone is buying products from us. So what is the product name? We want to see some categories and subcategories for our products. We want to see the sales for this product, some quantity. So this is just a normal operational table I have. Another table which can be really useful for our Tableau server is a people table. So the people table is nothing else like just two columns with a region and a name. So we call these people our regional managers. So you see that Anna is a regional manager for the region West, Chuck is for East, Kelly for Central, and Cassandra for South. And I can use this table later to join it with my order table. And you see in our order table, we also have a column called region. So I can say every time the region is South, I can add a new column with the regional manager name. And later I can use this column and use it in my Tableau server to set some permissions and grant only the people right access. So maybe when Anna logs in, she can only see the South region. So that's the idea. That is the reason why I want to use these names for our examples. So we want to add some new users. And the first username I want to add is, in this case, Anna. So I'll just copy and paste her name. Let's go back to our Tableau server and we want to add a new user. So when we want to add a new user, you see that we can also import a file with users. And that makes sense when you have a lot of users. So let's say you have hundreds of users. You don't want to type in all the names, all the email addresses, and so on and so on. Then you can be lazy and just import a file with all the users in there. You can also use Active Directories and so on and so on. So there are more easy way how you can add users. But because we only have four users, we make it just really manually for now. So we want to add a new user. And the first thing is the username. So I can type in Anna. And the display name is just Anna. I need a password for her. And again, I don't need an email. And what is really important is the site role. So I can say that Anna has a site role, which gives her the right permissions to our projects. And I can define it directly right here. So what I can use in our site role is I can say, okay, she's unlicensed, so she's not using any license, but she is still as a user in our Tableau server. Or I can use her as a viewer. So most of the people who are looking at your dashboard later will be viewers. So they're only interacting with the dashboards you will build for them. So let's say you are creating a dashboard. You can be an explorer, can publish, or you can be a creator, or of course a site administrator. And that means that you are working more with Tableau Desktop. You're creating your analysis, you're publishing everything to Tableau Server, and later other people are using your dashboards. So they're just looking at them, they're filtering their data. So these people are normally called a viewer. So in our case, Anna is just a viewer, so let's make her a viewer. She's only looking at the dashboards we create later. So that's absolutely fine. And maybe I typed in the wrong password. So now it is the right one, perfect. So let's add her as a user. And you see now we have our first user, that is Anna. So let's do it a few more times. So the same with Chuck, so we add a new user. So we need them for our examples. And the display name is Chuck. We give him a password. And again. So in this case, we will say he will be an explorer and he can also publish things to our server. So this is his side role. So Anna was just a viewer. Chuck will be an explorer, can publish. So we can add him. So he will be our second. So now let's add Kelly, another user. Display name is Kelly. We give her a password. And she will also be a viewer. Perfect. So the last one is Cassandra. Let's add her as a user. And she will be unlicensed. So she's not working in our company anymore. She's not using Tableau, but she should stay in our Tableau server. So maybe later she's an external person and we don't need to give her a license all the time. So, okay, now we have our first users. And to make sure that everything works fine, I want to test it now. So what I do is I'm working with Chrome with my Chrome browser, and I want to switch to my Safari browser because here in our Safari browser I have an empty window with my Tableau server. So you see it's our Penguin Bistory server. That's our server at Tableau at Bistory. So I can test now all these names. So let me log in with as Anna maybe. So Anna. I type in her name and her password, and I don't want to save this password because I'm deleting this users directly after our call. And you see that I can go to her homepage. She has access to a few things. I can go to explore and she can see our skill up folder. So now I'm logged in as Anna. That's actually fine. So just keep in mind when it's an A here, that's Anna. When it's AP, that is me. That's Alexander Philippe. That's a problem that we both start with the same name. So what you can see is that I can log in as Anna, and that absolutely works fine. So in our first example, let's wait a few seconds. So let's put everyone in a group, because just imagine that we have different, could be more than just four users. We have hundreds of users. So it will be really hard to set the right permissions for hundreds of users all the time. So we make sure that we put them into different groups. So the group is also here on the left side. So when I click on group, you see that we have a group called all users. And we have in this group, we have five users. So all the users I have are in this all user group. There's also another group called Alex. That's me again. And we want to make sure that we add a few more now. So we add a new group and we call this group maybe Anna and Chuck. And I will grant them a role at the beginning. So every time they log in, they can get a new site role. So this will be the minimum role or the minimum site role they will have when they log in into Tableau Server. So just keep in mind that Anna has the site role as a viewer, and now I grant her the possibility to be an explorer, can publish all the time. So next time I log in as Anna, she will be an explorer, can publish. That's something I can also define when I create a new group. So let's create this one. So and this is my Anna and Chuck group. And you see here the minimum site role is explorer can publish. So let's create another one. That one was Kelly and Cassandra. And they will be a viewer. So these are my two groups now, and you see that I can put different users now in this group. So let's go into the Anna and Chuck group, and you see, oh, there is no user yet. So in this group, we have to add some users. So we go to add users, and I say, okay, in my Anna and Chuck group, we choose Anna and Chuck, and we add them both to this group. So I go back on all groups, and let's do the same for Kelly and Cassandra. And now they are both in this group. So when I go back to my group section here on the side, you see I have my Alex group, I have all the users, and I have Anna and Chuck and Kelly and Cassandra as one group. So let's go back to Safari. So you see when I log in as Anna, I will be able to see the skill up folder. But let's say we have a lot of employees in my company, and not everyone should be allowed to see this project all the time. So only the people who are allowed to see this project should see that this project already exists, and everyone else cannot see anything. So to do this, we have to change our permissions on this project. So I go back to my administrator account, and I go to explore on the side here. What I can do now is for our SkillUp project, I can set different permissions. So I can just click on the three dots, choose permissions. And now it's getting a little bit more interesting, because what we can do now is you see that all users, they will all see this project. So what I do is I take away the access that everyone can see my project. And another thing you can see is that when I click on all users, we will have a list of all the users here on the bottom, and we can directly see who can do something. So in this case now, Anna cannot see my project anymore. So when I go back to Safari, and let's refresh our site, and I hope that works, and you see Anna cannot see my SkillUp project anymore. So this is absolutely fine. So let's go back to my account, and I want to add maybe a group. So maybe I have a group of sales reps for a specific country, and I want these sales reps to see my dashboard. So I can type in a group, and I see I have my Anna and Chuck group here, and I want to use this group and give them some possibilities. So maybe what I can also do is I can always change the permissions here, or I can use maybe a template. So I can say they can only view my project, or they can publish to my project, or the access is completely denied. And I say, okay, they can publish to this project. And I save this one. A few other things when we talk about permissions is that you can set permissions for different things in your project. So like what we see here is we are on the project level. So we can say, okay, someone can see it, or someone can publish to this project, but nothing else. When we go to the workbooks, we can directly say what the people can do with their workbooks. So again, they can see the workbooks inside this project. They can maybe filter in our workbooks. They can make some comments, or they can view different comments in a workbook, or they can write their own comments. They can download some images of our dashboards, or they can download the summary data. So let's say you're creating a bar chart, and they want to download the data behind this bar chart, they are allowed to do this. And you see that when we look at the workbook level, we can do a lot of more things than just going to our project. So here we can only select view and publish. And on a workbook level, we can do a lot of more things like web edit. We talk about web edit later. And so how we can give people the possibility to play around with something like Tableau Desktop, but directly in your browser. And then here we can say, okay, they are allowed to do this or not. The same with data sources and data roles, and also different flows you publish to your server, and also metrics. So you can choose for every different things you can publish in your project, you can specify the right permissions for the people. What I also want to do is I want to click here on the content permissions, and I say, okay, these permissions I set here in my project are also locked to all the elements inside my project. Like, so when I set some permissions here, every element inside my project will also have the same permissions. So I only do it once on a project level and not on a workbook or data source level or whatever. So I do it one time on the project level, and this should be fine. So the really good thing is that every time you click here on something, so maybe all user, so when I go to workbooks, I click on all the users, I can directly see all the permissions for all the users. Maybe you remember that Cassandra was unlicensed, so she's not allowed to do anything in our Tableau server. And because I'm the site administrator again, and I'm also the owner of the project, because I created the project, I'm the owner of the project, I can do everything in here. So let's close this one. Let's go into our SkillUp folder, and you see here again, I am the owner of the project. So, but what I can do is I can change the owner. So let's say I create this project, but someone else is working on this project, so I can make him the owner. What I can also do is when I go back to Explore, and I go to my permissions again, and I go to the Anna and Chuck group, I can also say, okay, I want to set them as a project leader. So maybe I will stay the owner of our project, but I make someone else the project leader. So that gives them also more possibilities and more permissions to do something in our projects. So just keep in mind, you can also add only one person and not a group of persons and then make them the project leader. So this is absolutely fine. The next thing I want to do with you is I want to create a small dashboard. So let's talk about different permissions and what we can do with dashboards. So the first thing I want to do is I want to create a dashboard with you really quick. It's just a few minutes. So I open Tableau Desktop, and you see my Tableau Desktop is completely empty at the beginning. So I want to connect it to a data source, and I use a Microsoft Excel file, and here I just select our Superstore. So I just remember that Superstore is just an Excel file here, so we can open this one. So I want to see my order table in Tableau Desktop. And what I need now is I want to join my people table, so I get a new column with all my regional managers. That's really interesting, so we can use it later to set some permissions who can see what in a dashboard. So I also join it with my people table. Perfect. I make it an extract. That's fine. And I go to my first sheet. I quickly create, so I have to save this one first. And I want to replace this one. That's absolutely okay. So I'm going to create a few visualizations now. So the first one should be just a simple map, and I want to see my, where is it? All my states, maybe my country regions in here. I want to see some sales and some profits. I make this a little bit bigger. So, you know, the SkillUp is not about talking about Tableau Desktop, it's more about Tableau Server, but before we do something, let's create a few small visualizations. So something like this, that's absolutely fine. This one is called our map. The second one should be just a list of all the subcategories from our products. And again, I want to see the sales. So my profit should be on color. The sales should be here. And I make this one bigger. And you see here, our tables are really bad. So we make a lot of sales, but we have negative profit in here. So that they are not really performing good. So this is sales and profit by subcategory. So the next one I want to create is, because I need three visualizations for some examples, is just some data over time. So what I do is I quickly create a time axis here. And again, I want to see my sales. And this is also, just give them some numbers. That's absolutely good. So let's call this timeline. And I quickly want to create a dashboard. So let's change the size of this dashboard a little bit. And let's get our map. It's just drag and drop, so we just need a dashboard, a really dirty dashboard, and that's absolutely fine for us. So what I want to show you is, so let's use a region filter maybe. So I want to see a filter for our regions. Oh, come on. So I want to go in here, and you see that, let's use the persons, that's also fine. So I want to use the person as a filter. Let's use this one, persons, and this should affect everything in our data source. So, and we want to create a multi-drop-down field. So what I can do now is I can choose different persons. So in this case, maybe Anna, and I only see the region for Anna, only her data everywhere. Or maybe I want to choose Cassandra. I can see the Cassandra region and all her data. So I'm just using a normal filter. So the first thing I want to show you in our first dashboard example is, so let's get rid of this legend. I don't need legend. I just want to see the filter on the side. So this is absolutely fine. I want to publish this dashboard we create in Tableau Desktop to our Tableau server in our SkillUp project. So to do this, we have to go to server here on the top. We have to sign in into our server. In this case, it's our Bistory server, and I'm signed into my personal site, and I want to publish this workbook now. So I click on Publish Workbook. So the first thing I can do is choose the project. And here is our new SkillUp project, the one we created directly in Tableau Server. So I can choose it now. And I can choose a name for this one. So test dashboard one. So we will create multiple dashboards over this SkillUp. So we can define if the data source should refresh itself all the time. So maybe once a month, once a week, every 15 minutes, whatever we want to choose. So when I click on the refresh, I'm using really static data because Tableau Superstore is static data. It's not changing, so I don't want the data to be refreshed. So everything else should be fine. So I go and publish my work, my dashboard to Tableau Server. You see, after it's published, Tableau Server will directly open and it says, okay, publishing complete. Everything is published to our SkillUp folder. And here is our dashboard. So what I can do is I can click on dashboard now and I can directly use it. That's absolutely what we want. So we create a dashboard in Tableau desktop, then we publish everything to our server and make sure that everyone else can see this dashboard. So let me quickly split my screen a little bit. So I take my Chrome browser to the left, to the right side. So I'm logged in as Alexander Philippide, and I also want to take my Safari browser and put it here on the left side. So, and I want to refresh the page. So here I'm logged in as Anna, and here I'm logged in as me. So, and Anna is still not able to see my SkillUp project. So let's make sure that she has the right permissions to see our project. So I go back into my, so the reason why I split this is because I can do something in my administrator view, and then I can directly see the result in Anna's view. So let's go to the SkillUp training again. So let's look at our permissions. And so what can they do? So they are not allowed to do anything here. So Anna is just a viewer. That's absolutely okay. So let's take away this one. Let's take out the permissions. Let's save this one. And now you see Anna is allowed to see everything, but she's not allowed to publish because she's just a viewer. So let's refresh the page, and you can see that, hey, we have our SkillUp project, and Anna can see our SkillUp project. And she can also see our first dashboard. So she can see and she can use the dashboard we create in Tableau Desktop, and we publish this one to Tableau Server. So when I open this one and I go to dashboard, she can start using this dashboard. But she's not allowed to filter. So let's use someone else. So let's say I sign out. And now I will log in as Chuck, because Chuck was, I think he has more permissions. So let's use his username and his password. I don't want to save this password. Nope. And again, maybe I typed in the wrong password. Nope, I don't want to save this. So, and now you see I'm logged in as Chuck. So I have this C here, and he is allowed to use my SkillUp project. He can also see my test dashboard, so he can open the dashboard. But he's also not allowed to do anything. So let's again look at our permissions. Oops, where is it? Google Chrome. So what can Chuck and Anna do? So Chuck can see the project. He can publish something to the project. Let's go on to our workbook level. You see, they are not allowed to filter. So what I do here is I just select all the permissions and all the users to none, so they don't have any permissions. Then I go to my Anna and Chuck group, and they are not allowed to do anything here, so I just give them some Explorer views. And I save everything, and now you see that Chuck, so now we see Chuck's permissions. He's allowed to filter data, he can download some data. He can do a little bit more than Anna, because Anna was just a viewer and Chuck is an Explorer. And he can publish things. So let's go back to Safari and let's refresh our dashboard. And you see now he is allowed to filter our dashboard, so he can see something here. So what he can do now is he can maybe change this one to his view. So now he can see his personal dashboard, because normally what we see is all the data. So we see all the United States here, but maybe, so the idea is that we create one dashboard. We have multiple users that will use our dashboard. And normally we have more than one filter here on the site. So we have, sometimes we have 10 or 20 filters. Don't use 20 filters really. That's not best practice, I think. But let's say every time Chuck is opening his dashboard, he wants to directly see his data. So 20 people are using the same dashboard, and every time they want to see a custom view of this dashboard. How can they do this? So let's filter to only Chuck. So he can use this filter, and he can use a lot of more filters, maybe a specific timeline or whatever, a date range, and so on and so on. And what he can do now, so when he is logged in as Chuck, he can use or create his own personal view. So when he clicks here on View Original, he can name this view. And I call this one My Own View. And I can make this one my default view. And I can also make this visible to others. I don't want to do this, but I just want to save this one now. And let me go back to all our projects, and I open it again to just show you what will happen now. So when I go to our SkillUp project, here's our first test dashboard. I go into my dashboard, and it will be directly filtered to Chuck. So every time I'm logged in as Chuck, and I want to look at this dashboard, it's directly filtered to my data. So the problem is now that maybe Chuck, maybe he is a bad guy, he can choose, or he can change the filter. So he can look at Anna's data, and he can compare his data with Anna's data. So maybe he is not allowed to see Anna's data. So the idea that we have at the moment is we give them one dashboard, and everyone can see all the data. They can create their personal views, which is absolutely fine, but sometimes we don't want to give them the chance to see other data. So every time we want to make sure that every time Chuck logs in into his dashboard, he can only see his data and nothing else. So how can we do this? Let's go back to Tableau desktop. So here we created our dashboard already, and what I can do is I can use something like a user filter. So when I go into a visualization and I click here on server, I can create a user-specific filter. So, and I can create maybe a filter for a specific person. So let's go to a person. So what you can see here on the site is, here I can see all the users on my sites and all the groups on my sites. So I can open some different groups. So what I can do now is I can say Chuck is only allowed to see Chuck's data. Kelly is only allowed to see Kelly's data. Cassandra can only see Cassandra's data, and Anna is only allowed to see Anna's data. And we can give this filter a name. I just call it user filter 1. That's absolutely fine. So what Tableau Desktop is now doing, it's creating a filter we can use in our dashboard. So what I can do now is I can just drag it here on our filter section, and I see nothing anymore. Why can I see not any? Why can't I see anything anymore? Because I can see it from the view of Alexander Philippide. I'm opening Tableau Desktop, and here on the bottom side, you can see, I see everything from the view of myself. And I have no permissions to this different persons. So what I can do is I can say, okay, give me this dashboard from the view of Chuck. So when I logged in as Chuck, so he should be able to see his data. Come on, where is it? I have to throw away our person filter now. So I can simulate how my dashboard will look from someone else. So in this case, that's Chuck's view. So let's change this one maybe to Anna's view. Absolutely fine. And I can use my view again, but because I have absolutely no permissions, that's the reason why I see just a blank screen. But a user filter is something we can now use. So let's make sure this one will be applied to all using this data source. You see the small data base symbol now on the side. So now all the visualizations will use this data source filter. And because I'm looking at this dashboard in my personal view, I'm not able to see anything. But that is absolutely not a problem. Let's publish this one again. So let's publish this workbook. So this will be now test dashboard number 2. Now, in this case, I don't want to see all the sheets. I don't want to publish all the sheets I created, because I created the map, then my sales and profit, my subcategory, my timeline, and my dashboard, which is a combination of all the three visualizations before. So in this case, I only want to publish the dashboard and not everything else, because It's enough to see the dashboard. So I have to add a thumbnail user because so let's use Anna in this case to create a thumbnail later on my server. I show this in a minute. And let's publish our second dashboard. So that's great. So it will directly open Tableau Desktop or Tableau Server again. We can directly see our dashboard. That's a thumbnail I see. So that's from Anna's view. So it's creating this view from Anna. So let me open this one. Oh, you see an empty dashboard, right? So the reason why I see an empty dashboard now is because I'm logged in as Alexander Philippide, and I don't have any regions in there. So I'm not allowed to see any regions. So let's go back to Tableau, to my Safari browser where I'm logged in as Chuck. And let's go to our SkillUp project. And here you see now test dashboard 1, test dashboard 2. Let me open test dashboard 2. I think I made, okay, that's absolutely fine. So what you can see here is he can see the data only for his specific region. So let me log out and let me log in as Anna in this case again. So I need her name again, so I just copy and paste her name. Nope, I don't want to save this password. I go to Explore again, and here I have my SkillUp folder. And also Anna is allowed to see dashboard number 2. But you see when I logged in as Anna, I directly see a different region. So that means I can create one dashboard, and I can give different people not only a permission if they can see the dashboard or not, or if they can download some data or not, or some data services or whatever. I can also make sure directly in Tableau Desktop who can see what. So, and this is actually what a user filter can do. There's also many more ways how you can set the right security for your dashboard. So we can also create something like row level security. That means for every row of data, we have a name, we can use this name and make sure that I think I can quickly show you what I mean. So let's go back to Tableau Desktop quickly. Let's add a new empty sheet. And what we have is we have in our data source, we have the person column. And in my person column, so let's take away the user filter, I have just the names of all my regional managers. And what I can also do is I can create a new calculated field and use a function called username. So something like this. Let me call it username and click on OK. And what is the username doing? So let's put it here on the side. It gives you the name of the person that is logged into Tableau Server or to your Tableau Server now. And depending what I simulate now in Tableau Desktop, so let's change this one to Anna. You see now it's simulating Anna in this case. So what I can do is if the person Anna is the same like my username Anna, then I can see all the rows for her. So what I can do is I can just create a new calculated field and say the person should be the same like maybe my username. So you can also use something like this to secure your data. That's called row level security. So every row of data belongs to a specific person. And then we make sure that the name of this person is compared to this row, and if it's true, then we can show it. If it's false, we take everything out. This is something we can also directly use in Tableau Server, because you see, depending on who logs in into your dashboard later, will be the username. What we can also use is here on the side, we can use we can filter your users. We can use a full name, or if they are a member of a group, we can use some domain names and so on. So you have different options to compare something to a specific row in your data when you want to use row-level security. The other example I showed you was just to create a user filter here. And for a user filter, you can say, OK, you see that you have all your different dimensions here on the side, like the regions. And then I can say, OK, maybe Anna is allowed to see region east and south. Cassandra is allowed to see west and central, and so on and so on. So this is something you can do directly in Tableau Server, or you can do it from a database side when you give every row the right permission. That's just a few words about permissions in Tableau Server. So there's many more steps how you can secure data. But just keep in mind, the idea is to create one dashboard and multiple people will use them. They can create their own views. So if they are allowed to see all the data, they can create their personal views, and they can filter on specific things, and every time they open a dashboard, they directly see everything filtered for them. Or we make sure that they can really only see their data, and so like in our case, so when I log in as Anna, I'm only allowed to see Anna's territory, or maybe Chuck's territory, or whatever. So in this case, Anna is not allowed to see anything else. But just a small thing, you have to make sure that the people who are looking at your dashboard are not allowed to maybe download the whole dashboard. So because if they download the whole dashboard, they can just take your filter, throw it away, and they can see all the data again. So you have to make sure in the permission tables that they are not allowed to download the workbook itself, and they cannot open it with Tableau Desktop, or they are also not allowed to download some the data source. So in this case, when I click here on download, you see that she's not allowed to download the data and also not allowed to download our Tableau workbook. This is something you can also set directly in the permissions if they're allowed to do anything. In this case, Anna is not able to download the dashboard, throw away your filter and see maybe Chuck's data. So it's not possible for her. So there's a few more things I want to show you. So let's say she wants to change this dashboard. So I'm logged in as Anna again, and let's do something else. I think that's something I can directly show you from my view. So I go back to Chrome, where I'm logged in as a site administrator. So I have all the possibilities, so I can show you a few cool features in Tableau. Let me jump to test dashboard one again. That's not what I want. I want to see the dashboard itself. And maybe for a small example, in Tableau Desktop, before you publish something, you can choose the sheets you want to publish. And you can. What I did in our first dashboard is I published the dashboard, and I also published every sheet separately. And then it looks like this. So every sheet will be in here, and then we also see our dashboard. When I go to my test dashboard 2, I only see the dashboard. That was the reason why I unchecked all the different sheets, because normally I'm not interested in the different visualizations I created. I just want to see the dashboard itself. But because in this dashboard I don't have the right permissions to see anything, I have to go back to test dashboard 1, and let's open this one. So great. There's a few things I want to show you now, like maybe I want to change the color of this bar charts. So what I did is I created this dashboard in Tableau Desktop, and then I published everything to Tableau Server. But if I'm not really happy with this one, so I show this one to my client, and my client says, okay, I don't like the colors, can we quickly change it? So normally I have to download the whole dashboard, I have to change the colors, publish everything again, and then everything is fine. But I can also do it directly with our web edit function. So here on the top you can see edit. And what will happen now is it will open something like Tableau Desktop directly in your browser. So you can see all my dimensions here on the side, all the measures I have in here, my marks card. So I can just click on this one. I can change the colors maybe to an orange. So it looks like this. I go back to my dashboard, and it's done directly in my browser. So I don't have to download anything. I don't have to play around with Tableau Desktop. Everything is directly in Tableau Server. And what I think is that's really the future. So I think that when this is... So let's say you have nearly 90% of the functions from Tableau Desktop in Tableau Web Edit. So you can do a lot of things. There's a few things you cannot do in Web Edit, but I think in the future that will also be possible. But I think that's absolutely a great feature that you have something like Tableau Desktop in your browser, so you can do your own analysis directly in here. So what I can do now is, after I change maybe the color, I can just click on File and I save this one, or I can save it as a new version. I just overwrite the existing one, so the new color will be orange now. So workbook is saved. I go back, so I close the web edit function. And you see, when I look at my dashboard, everything will be orange now. And I can do, of course, anything else I can do, nearly anything else I can do in Tableau Desktop. Okay, so this is web edit. What you can also do is, when we go back to our SkillUp project, so let me go to the permissions again. So let's go to the workbooks. Web edit is actually here. So at the moment, Chuck and Anna, they are allowed to use the web edit function. So they are also allowed to use web edit. This is really critical in this case, because let's say we use a user filter again, and they're not on a data source site. They are just somewhere in our visualization. What they can do is just go into this visualization and throw away our user filter or any filter we have. So maybe we have to make sure that they are not allowed to use the web edit function. So they are not allowed to go into your visualization and throw it away. Maybe there's something you can do. So you can also put it in a data source filter, so they are not allowed to change anything there. But you see here that they have the permissions to use web edit. So make sure that a viewer is not normally allowed to use this one. So, but that's something you can also do in the permissions here. So when I log in as Chuck or Anna, they can use web edit and a lot of more things. Maybe they're not. They shouldn't do this. Okay, so let's go back to SkillUp and to our first dashboard. And there's a few more things I want to show you. Something like, so the idea is, again, so you publish a workbook like this dashboard, and you don't want to look at this dashboard all the time. So it's not like every morning you come into your company, you will open Tableau Server, you have to look at your dashboard. Maybe there's nothing interesting in this dashboard. So what you can make sure is that you only get maybe a notification, like an email, when something really important is happening. So that is called an alert in Tableau Server. So what we can do is, let's click on alert. You see that we have no alerts at the moment, so I can create one. So, and to create one, I have to click on a numeric axis. So maybe like this one. So I click here and I click create. And what I can do now is, you see this new line I create, so maybe we make sure, so the condition to use this alert, so now I can set a condition to use my alert. So maybe if my number is, let's say below this one, that's absolutely fine. And you see we have some bars below this one, so I want to make sure that I get an alert now. So what we can just set the line here and say, okay, what will happen when our data is below this line or maybe equal to this line or whatever. So I can give it a subject and I can say, okay, daily at most. So I can, it is checking it once a day, or I want to trigger it now. So I use first time when it's true. So, and who's getting this alert? It's only me for this one. So I create this alert now. And you see it's never triggered. That's not true. So when I click on this one, still never triggered. Let's go back. And you see now it was triggered 5 seconds ago. So the first trigger was run because we have some bar charts under the specific value. So what I can do is now I can go to my email and let's update this one. And you see I have a new email from our server, and in this email I directly get a notification with my dashboard and it tells me, okay, hey, here's something wrong. So again, the idea is that you don't have to check all your dashboards all the time. So let Tableau Server do the rest for you. So you just set a specific value, and if it's maybe below or bigger than this value, then you get a notification, and then you can say, okay, damn, there's something wrong. I click on this picture, and it's directly now pointing me to my dashboard in Tableau Server. So absolutely brilliant feature, I think. So that was called an alert. Something else you can do is that you can get a subscription. So let's click on subscription. That means getting an email maybe once a day. So every morning you come into your company, you will receive an email with a picture of your dashboard. So first I have to add a user, so I subscribe myself. And I can also say I want to see the entire workbook or maybe just this view. Because a workbook can be more than just one dashboard. A workbook can be multiple visualizations, it can be a story, it can be more than one dashboard. But maybe I'm just interested in this view, so this is absolutely fine. And I can also say, so if there's nothing in this view, don't send me anything. What I can also do is I can change this view to a PDF view, or I want to receive an image and also a PDF. In this case, just an image is fine for me. Subject can stay the same. And I can also type in some messages like, so hello, good morning, this is your daily dashboard, and so on and so on. So here's the frequency, so when data refreshes, so that means when every time your data source in the background, so maybe in this case our superstore is refreshing its data, then I get a new subscription, or maybe I can set a specific schedule here. And what schedule I want, I want it every weekday morning. So every time I come into my organization, I will have an email with an overview of my dashboard. So I can click on subscribe now. And when I click here on subscribe, I can also manage my subscriptions. And here you can see that I have all my subscriptions in here, and what I can do now is I think I can unsubscribed it, I can unsubscribe it again. And you see that I get a subscription every weekday morning, so I go into this subscription now and I want to trigger it now. Come on, where is it now? So all schedules, and you see here I have a lot of schedules when some, maybe an extract will refresh, when a flow will refresh, and also my weekday mornings subscription, and I can run it now, so I can show you that I will receive an email. So I think that will take a few seconds again. So let me go back to this one, my SkillUp folder here, and you see here that's my subscription. So just imagine that every Monday or every morning I get an email with this picture again. I can type in some text, I can manage my subscription or unsubscribe to this one again, or I can just click on this image and it will directly point me to my dashboard again, which is absolutely cool, I think. So maybe there's something you don't want to do, maybe only if there's an alert, then you can use the alert function. But of course, there's more. So maybe you don't want to check your dashboard all the time. So in this case, you just want to see maybe a specific number, and this one is called a metric. So we can see a metric. So let's first create one, and then I say a few words about this one. So you can select a specific mark in your visualization and check this number all the time. That means every time you go into your SkillUp project, you will see this one number, and you will see if this goes up or down. So maybe our tables, because I told you our tables, they really have a bad profit all the time. And here you see now we have a metric here on the side. In this case, this one is our sum of sales. Maybe the sales are not really important, so I want to change the measure to my profit. And here you can see now we can directly check our negative profit for our tables. And that's exactly what I want to do. So I have to make this a little bit smaller because my picture is here. So I have to create this metric now. And let's see what this metric will do. So if I go back to my SkillUp project now, so you see that we have dashboard 1, dashboard 2, and there's also a new element here, and this is actually the metric we created before. So I don't have to go into my first dashboard, and I don't have to click on tables again every time. I just take this number, and it always shows me this number directly when I go to my SkillUp project, which is absolutely really cool. So I don't have to go inside my dashboards and maybe set some filters all the time and whatever. So I directly see the number here, and you see it's refreshed 1 minute ago, and it also will refresh every time. So let's quickly create another metric. So what I did is I created a metric from our tables, but maybe I want to use a timeline here. So I again click on metrics. And now in this case, I use a mark on my timeline. And let's see what we have. So it's, I think it's just the sum of sales. That's absolutely fine. The cool thing is, so when we create this one, and we go back to our SkillUp, you see that because it's not really a number, now we use a timeline, that we can directly see the timeline here, and we see the change in percent compared to the mark before all the time. So here you see our numbers are going down, so my sales are going down, and it's minus 47% compared to the month before. So I don't have to go into this dashboard anymore, I can directly see this number, and everything is done. So it's really easy for you to really check everything. So let me see what else I want to show you. So we talked about a custom view. So let's say you can see all the data and you can select all your filters at the beginning. Then you can create your own custom view. That means that every time you log in into your dashboard, you see everything pre-filtered for you. And you can make this your personal view all the time. We talked about alerts. We saw what a metric is. We talked about subscription and web editing stuff. Of course, you can share your dashboards. And you can download specific things, and you see, because I'm the site administrator, I'm allowed to do everything here. So I can download data, the Tableau workbook, but I can take away these permissions, and I should do this because not everyone should be allowed to download the whole dashboard with all the data in the background. So another thing I want to show you in our SkillUp project. So you see here we have two metrics. We uploaded two, or we published two different dashboards. What we can also do is we can just publish a data source. So the idea of publishing a data source is that maybe you are the team who's creating data sources all the time. You're not an analyst. You have a team of analysts somewhere, but you are the team who's creating the data sources. And so you want to make sure that the analysts who are directly working in Tableau Server, they can do all their analysis. And you don't have to do this because you only take care about your data. So let's just publish a data source without any analysis behind this one. So every time, normally when we publish a workbook, the data is inside this workbook, but we can, of course, publish the data source separately. And let's quickly do this. Let me quickly rename our data source here on the site. Otherwise, it's fine. It's fine. So we just come on, publish data source, and I want to publish this one. So I can give it a name. It's just my Superstore data source. So without any dashboard, it's just the data itself. So the analysis team can do all the stuff later based on the published data source I'm creating now. So of course I can again change the extract, refresh, so maybe every 50 minutes again, and so on and so on. And I can also say, okay, when it's published to our Tableau server, also please update the one I am using in Tableau Desktop now. So in this case, the small symbol here will not be an extract, which is on my PC. It will now directly connect to this published data source on our Tableau server. I can quickly show you what I mean. Let's quickly do this one. And let's publish this data source. So perfect. So here again, we are in our SkillUp project and the Superstore data source is published. And when I go back to Tableau Desktop, you see that the small database symbol on the site now changed to a Tableau logo. And that means we're using a data source that is published in Tableau server directly now. So it's not on my PC anymore. I mean, it's still on my PC, but this specific workbook is not using the one which is on my PC. Now we'll use the one that is published on published in Tableau server. So let's go again to our SkillUp project. So again, we see our two metrics here. We have our two dashboards. And here we see a new one, which is my new data source I already published. And it's just a data source, no dashboard behind this one. So we can make sure that all these data sources, let's say we have a Microsoft SQL server, we have hundreds of different tables, and we wrote a lot of custom SQL. So there's really tons of work of creating a data source. And we want to publish this one. We really want to rename everything so the analysis team can use this one later. So what they can do is they can just go to your data source and they can start creating a new workbook directly from your data source. So if you're not maybe a viewer cannot do this, but so if you have the right permissions, you can just click on new dashboard and you can directly start here and say, okay, maybe the regions, I want to see for every regions, I want to see my sales, and I can start doing my analysis based on a published data source. So let me close this one, and I don't want to save this. Another really cool thing that we have when we are directly in a data source is that Tableau tries to understand your data. So it's a quite new feature, which is called Ask Data. And you see here that Tableau will give you all your different dimensions, all the different measures we have. And when we hover with our mouse over all these dimensions and measures, we can see how our data looks like. That's really good when you have maybe you have some dirty data, you want to you're expecting some null values somewhere, you can directly see here how is your data distributed. And so Tableau tries to understand what your data is. And what you can also do is, because of Ask Data, I can just say, give me sales by country. And I press enter. Oh, Tableau asks me, oh, you want to see the sum of sales by country? And yes, that's absolutely fine. And now Tableau is doing the rest for me. So with Ask Data, I can just type in what exactly I want. And Tableau is trying to build a visualization for me based on the question I asked before. And if I'm not happy with maybe a map view, I can also change the view here on the side and I can make it a bar chart again. So I can just ask the data source what I want and Tableau is doing the rest, which is really cool, I think. So it's trying to understand the data for you. So that was actually the Ask Data feature. The last thing I want to show you for today for our SkillUp is, so we saw metrics again, we saw our dashboards, a published data source. The last thing is I want to publish a data flow, so with Tableau Prep. In this case, I just opened Tableau Prep, and in Tableau Prep, I already have a prepared data flow. That's just a simple Superstore again. And here we have different data sources. It can be anything. So this one could be an Excel file. The next one a CSV file. Then we have a Microsoft SQL server. And maybe, I don't know, could be anything, actually. Now we are preparing our data. So let me look at this data. Or maybe let's go to the first cleaning step. So you see how our data is built. And then I go and I union my data later, I clean my data, I join it together with some other tables like my return table, I pivot my data. And the idea of creating a flow like this is that you really change the data. Normally you have to write a lot of SQL code and you don't have to do this anymore, which is really, really cool. It's a more visual way how you can interact with your data. And the idea is that you will receive an output file, and this output file can be directly used as a published data source in Tableau Server, or you can directly fill your dashboards with this output files. So what we want to do is, so the idea should be that we create a flow like this, and we want to publish this flow so that it runs automatically, maybe once a day, or every night, or I don't know, whatever you want. So we can also use Tableau Server to automatically run this flow we created before. So I can go to publish flow, so again to server, I have to log in into my server, and then I can just publish this flow. And let's see what will happen now. Okay, I think I'm signed in. That should be fine. So I was running in a few problems, so I was just quickly restarting Tableau Prep. I hope you don't recognize the break, but so again, let's try to publish our flow. And here you can see I can choose a project again. So again, I can use my SkillUp project I created before together with you. I can give it a name, Superstore, let's call it Superstore Flow. I can give it again some descriptions and all my uploaded files and so on and so on. So you see, I also got a, we have a location, and this location is not on the safe list of our organization. So actually it's on my PC. So yeah, but that should be fine. So I'm going to publish this flow now. That again takes a few seconds. And you see, after this one is done, it's the same like publishing a data source or publishing a workbook. It will directly point you to the place where it is now in Tableau Server. And you see, when we go to our SkillUp project, again, now we have our Superstore flow already published in this one. And I can click on this. And you see that what I can do now is I have our output files here. And I can I can run it if I want. I can create a new data source based on this. It can run automatically. I can create new dashboards based on these output files. So it's absolutely great that you can do something like this. So when we look at our SkillUp project now, is that you can see that we have a lot of different things in our project, like the metrics, where we can directly see, okay, this is a specific number, and I'm always interested in this number. That's actually the profit for my tables. And I also want to see my sales over time, and oh, that's not good at the moment. So maybe if it's not really good like this, I can set an alert before, so I'm automatically will be informed if something is going wrong. I can use my subscriptions to get an email every day. I created different dashboards, and I can now use them. You see, when I go as Alexander Philippide to this dashboard, I'm not able to see anything because I'm using row level security for this one, and I have actually no access. So that's the reason why I cannot see anything here. So then we published a data source, which is just the Superstore, and we can just go to the Superstore and create new workbooks with a published data source, or we can just use Ask Data to do anything for us. And then we published a flow, and this flow can be run automatically every time you want, and it's creating new data source for your cool dashboards. And so I think Tableau Server is a really, really cool platform to really help you to analyze your data and make your life much easier. It's more than just giving you a good visualization. It does so many things more. So what I do is I hope you enjoyed our skill up training. And so again, we have a lot of other skill ups. Feel free to look at them. They're all published. So otherwise, have a good day and see you next time. Goodbye.